Today we're going to install the rear control arms for the Bronco 6G. Hey, it's Scott Becker with Metalcloak here. The Bronco rear control arms are built with the patented Duroflex bushings and are designed to self-center and provide maximum misalignment for the best flex and long-term performance for your lifted Bronco. Before we do the installation, let's go to metalcloakinstructions.com, print out the instructions, and read completely through them. Once we understand what we're getting into and we're certain we have all the necessary tools and skills, we can start in on the installation. Now let's go down to the shop and get started. Our Bronco is already in a safe location and ready to be worked on, so we're going to unbox the contents and verify that all the parts listed on the instruction page are accounted for before taking anything apart. Alright, it looks like we're good to go. The rear control arms will be installed here on the Bronco. To remove the rear control arms, you must remove the gas tank, but be sure the tank is supported before removing. Use a 9/32 socket and remove the hose clamp on the fuel filler neck. Disconnect the fuel vent line. Caution, this can be a little fragile. Remove the bolt securing the fuel tank in place using an 18mm socket. Before disconnecting the fuel feed lines and fuel return lines, make sure you have something down below to catch the fluid that may leak out and that the area is well ventilated. Disconnect the fuel feed and fuel return lines. Lower the tank 4 to 6 inches and disconnect the fuel pump and electrical connections and disconnect the two vent hoses. Completely remove the fuel tank and set to the side. Metalcloak recommends having a second person help remove the gas tank because it can be pretty heavy. Depending on the year or model, your Bronco may come with rear control arm covers. If your Bronco comes with the control arm cover, use a T25 Torx to remove this covering. Remove lower control arms using a 24mm socket. Using the stock lower control arms for reference, adjust the control arms to the same length eye to eye. Install the Duroflex lower control arm using the factory hardware with a 24mm socket. Remove the upper control arms using a 24mm socket. Using the stock upper control arms for reference, adjust the control arms to the same length eye to eye. Install the new upper control arm using a 24mm socket, making sure the jam nut end is at the axle. On the passenger side, at the frame, flip the bolt so the head faces outward. This will make it easier to access the lower control arm in the future. Tighten all control arm hardware. Reinstall the fuel tank. Metalcloak recommends again having a second person for this task. Reconnect the fuel pump electrical connection and the two vent hoses. At the front of the fuel tank, reinstall the fuel feed and fuel return lines. Reinstall the bolts securing the fuel tank in place using an 18mm socket. Reinstall the fuel vent line. Be careful, they can be fragile. Using a 9/32 socket and wrench, reinstall the hose clamp on the fuel filler neck. Now that we're all done, all there is to do is to go out and enjoy your Bronco. To learn more, visit us at metalcloak.com. Metalcloak, it's your Bronco, only better.